Welcome to How It Works, a video series from LawSites and LawNext, in which you get to see hands-on demonstrations of legal tech products directly from their developers. In today's episode, we're going to take a look at VerifAI, a Microsoft Word add-in from the contract lifecycle management company SpotDraft that uses generative AI to help lawyers review contracts up to 15 times faster. Joining me today to tell us about VerifAI and show us how it works is Rohith, Salim, co-founder and chief product officer at SpotDraft. Rohith, thank you so much for joining me today.
Awesome. Thanks for having me, Bob. Really excited to be here.
Why don't we start with having you tell us a little bit about SpotDraft and about why you developed VerifAI?
Yeah, sure. So SpotDraft is, as you mentioned earlier, an AI-driven contract lifecycle management platform. We power contracting at companies like Airbnb, Notion, Strava, and hundreds more across the globe. One of the things that we really pride ourselves on is that we work very, very closely with our customers. We listen to them, we work with them to really solve their problems. I personally like to say that SpotDraft itself was co-built with our customers. One of the things that we realized while in our journey to build a world-class CLM solution was that CLMs are great in that they unite the legal team with the rest of the organization. And there's definitely a place for that. That said, rolling out a new CLM solution, it often requires buy-in from a bunch of different stakeholders, and it usually takes some amount of time for you to start seeing ROI. Our CLM is basically our core product, and we continue to invest aggressively on there. But we wanted to create something that lawyers could use and see immediate value, which is why we built VerifAI, an AI-powered Word plugin to help lawyers review contracts 15 times faster than they usually would.
And for our readers, for our listeners rather, VerifAI is V-E-R-I-F-A-I. A clever play on the word. I like that. So why don't we jump into a demo and you can show us how it works.
Sure. So before we jump in, let's set the stage. Imagine it's 5 p.m. on a Friday. You have tickets to a show and you're just about to leave when a third-party contract lands on your desk. And as often, it needs to be reviewed ASAP. I'm sure a lot of the listeners here would have been in a similar situation like this at some point or another during their career. Imagine now if you could actually review this contract in a few minutes versus a few hours. That's the goal that we're trying to accomplish with VerifAI. This right here is a 13-page contract that we received from a vendor that we were trying to onboard at SpotDraft. We've gone ahead and changed the name of the vendor over here, but everything else in this contract is exactly the same. Typically, what ends up happening when someone ends up receiving a contract like this, or when a lawyer needs to review a third-party contract, is they'll end up going through the contract, and there's usually a mental checklist that they end up like following about things that are important to their organization that they'll end up keeping in mind when they're reviewing it. And whenever they spot an issue, they'll end up directly going ahead and making a red line, or they'll end up adding a comment for the counterparty, or sometimes they even just add a note for them to come back to it later, right? That's essentially the process that we've seen that lawyers follow when they're actually reviewing a third-party contract, right? Or reviewing any contract, really, but specifically third-party contracts. So as I said earlier, this is around a 13-page contract, and it would take a lawyer around anywhere from an hour to 2 hours to actually finish reviewing this contract. Now with VerifAI, what you can actually do is you can just go ahead and open it up right within Microsoft Word. And the reason why it's in MS Word is because it's the editor of choice for legal teams across the globe, right? And the moment you open it, you'll actually end up seeing a bunch of different guides in there. VerifAI comes preloaded with a bunch of standard guides that you can use out of the box and as a baseline for you to review specific types of agreements. And you can also go on to create your own guides if you'd like to. This is a software MSA that we receive from a vendor we're looking to onboard. So let's actually take a look at this vendor MSA review guide that I ended up setting up, right? And as you can see, like, there's a bunch of things that are important to me, right, when I'm reviewing the contract, or SpotDraft, rather, I should say, when we're reviewing the contract. So we have things like the governing law should be the state of New York, the service provider cannot assign its obligations to another party, et cetera, all written up over here, right? With VerifAI, rather than actually going through the entire contract, all you need to do is open up the relevant guide and hit run, right? And when that happens, basically what's going on is that VerifAI is scanning through the entire agreement in the background, and then it's actually checking for each and every one of these guidelines and figuring out what are the things that are met and what are the things that aren't met, right? So you can see how fast this is, essentially. The entire thing for a 13-page document happens in under a minute, right? And that's on the upper end. If you were to actually click into any guideline, this part is really cool. You know, we directly take you to that relevant portion of the agreement, which corresponds to that particular guideline. So I've clicked on this guideline, which says the governing law of this agreement should be the state of New York, right? And it's saying the guideline isn't met because the contract is stating that it's the state of California and not the state of New York as per the guideline, right? And I can verify this on the agreement as well, which says that, you know, hey, state of California without request, right? And it doesn't stop there. If I wanted VerifAI to actually suggest changes, I can just go ahead and click on this button here. And that's gone ahead and, like, you know, taken off California and added like New York, right? And it's not just gone ahead and changed the governing law, but it's also gone ahead and changed where exactly disputes are going to be resolved, because it doesn't make sense for the governing law to be New York and for disputes to continue to be resolved in a state court in San Francisco, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So that was an example. Let's pick something else over here, right? So there should be no penalties for late payments, right? And it has gone ahead and taken me to the payment of fees. So a lot of our users who use VerifAI, they find this incredibly valuable, you know? It sort of takes you to the relevant portion of the agreement really quickly, right? So you don't have to scan through everything to figure out where things are at and so on, right? And it's saying that, you know, it includes a penalty for late payments. So that's also mentioned here. Unless disputed in good faith, unpaid invoices may be subject to a finance charge of 1% per month on any outstanding balance, right? And again, you can use VerifAI to go ahead and suggest changes over here, and that's gone ahead and made the relevant edits. If for whatever reason you're not happy with whatever changes VerifAI has made, you can just command Z and it sort of undoes the changes that VerifAI has made, right? Let's do one more guideline and then let's actually take a pause to answer any questions. So again, another payment of fees clause. The agreement should not auto-renew without express written consent of the customer. Again, taking me to the termination clause, and it says that, you know, the initial service term is as specified in the applicable order form, and unless provided for otherwise in the order form, shall be renewed for additional terms only upon the written agreement of the parties, right? So exactly what you were hoping for over there. So yeah, more than anything, what we're really hoping for with VerifAI is it sort of helps a lawyer get over that initial sort of procrastination that they might end up feeling when they receive a third-party contract on their desk and they're just like, crap, there goes like the next 2 hours, right? And really sort of help you like speed through that first round of review really, really quickly. Any questions so far?
Well, I think my question is one I'm guessing you're about to answer, because I'm thinking a lot of viewers right now are wondering, how do they create these guides, or where do these guides come from?
Yeah. So great question there, Bob. So as I mentioned earlier, VerifAI comes preloaded with a bunch of standard guides, and you can end up using that, copy it, take it as your own, make edits to it, or you can end up going ahead and creating guides yourself. So let's actually go ahead and do that here, right? So I'm going to go ahead and basically I clicked on the create new guide button, and let's actually have you suggest a few guidelines? So Bob's guide for vendor MSA. Yeah? Why don't you suggest something, Bob, that you know you'd want to check for if you were being a vendor MSA?
Well, I would like to make sure that the payment terms in the agreement are at least 60 days.
Okay. Cool. So the customer should be allowed to make the payments within 60 days of receiving the invoice. So I've gone ahead and written this. It's in like simple English over here. There isn't really, but simple English for a lawyer, I guess. But yeah, there wasn't really any training or anything like that that we had to do. But I've just gone ahead and written this, and I can go ahead and click on the test button. So again, what this is sort of doing is that it's, again, going ahead and scanning through the entire document, right? And trying to find where in the document this particular guideline or language related to this guideline is related to. And it's going to come back with whether the guideline is met or not. Cool. So yeah, as you can see, it's again taking me to the payment of fees clause. It's saying the guideline isn't met. Let's actually see the details, right? And it says that the contract requires the customer to make payments within 30 days of receiving the invoice and not 60 days as per the guideline. So again, take me to the right clause and let's take a look at the subclause. Customer will be the service provider's applicable domain within 30 days of the date of invoice, right? Which is basically something that, you know, doesn't meet our guideline, and it sort of flagged it out as that. If I wanted to suggest changes, I can go ahead and do that. And it's just gone ahead and changed from 30 to 60. It's very, very focused in the set of track changes that it makes. It tries to minimize that. And yeah, if you're like happy with this, you can go ahead and add this to your guide, right? And we can add more and more guidelines as you sort of would want to, but high level, very, very simple to actually go on to add new guidelines, create a new guide, and so on.
And what's notable about that, as you pointed out, is that you're able to write the guideline in plain English. You don't have to worry about putting it in contract clause language or legalese. Write it in the form of a simple statement or query, and then it's able to use that and make that part of your guide.
Yep, exactly.
What else should we know about VerifAI?
This is something that sits within Microsoft Word. We've tried to keep this very, very focused to solve a core pain point that we've seen across legal teams across the world, you know, which is third-party paper review. And it was very, very, it would have been really easy for us to build a whole bunch of new features and so on and so forth. And it's not like we don't have like a huge backlog or a ambitious roadmap ahead, but we wanted to keep it really, really focused right now so that folks see value right away. Yeah, the other thing is that anyone can actually install VerifAI. You just need to go to spotdraft.com/verify, sign up for it. We'll set you up with an onboarding call. And anyone who comes from hearing this podcast, you guys, as long as you mention LawSites, we'll give you guys a 30-day free trial as well.
Fantastic. And you don't have to be a SpotDraft user to be able to use this product. This is a standalone product, right?
Yep. Completely standalone, can be used by anyone, irrespective of whether you're using SpotDraft, not using SpotDraft, using a different CLM, really doesn't matter.
Well, fantastic. Well, Rohith, I really appreciate your coming on the show today and telling us all about VerifAI. It's really interesting.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Bob. Appreciate it.
That's it for this episode of How It Works. You can find the full series of these videos at lawnext.com. You can also find them in the How It Works channel on YouTube. Look for it there. This is Bob Ambrogi. Thanks for watching.